Hey y'all, so the time has come. I am doing my full live reaction to my radio debut. It hasn't fully sunk in yet, and being able to say it out loud is just kind of a dream coming true. I think as an artist, we all have that mentality and that goal to eventually have our radio debut. And to say that mine finally is here and it's happening, and to make the story even more bonkers of a thing, it happened overseas. It's in the Netherlands being played on Dutch radio. And I have to thank Yup so much for making this happen. Not only has he been such a big champion for me, but he's been such a great friend, and he's an incredibly talented songwriter and artist as well. Because without him, I would never have had this opportunity. And thank you to Lucas On Air, who's the radio show that is playing More Hearts Than Mine. Like, never in a million years when I went into the studio to go record my version of More Hearts Than Mine did I think, oh, it's gonna go on radio, it's gonna do things. I just wanted it out because, you know, I did it on The Voice and I wanted something out there that was mine, that people were familiar with and they could kind of just hear it for what it was. Truly this song has done so much for me since we put it out, like, even before, like, you know, like I said, I did on The Voice, and when we got back, I gotta thank Keegan Farrell. He's the one that came up with the idea to go and record it and to do the version that I wanted to do by slowing it down. And, you know, he produced it and did every little detail and kind of got me in the right mind frame as well when we were in the studio with it. And, you know, we're currently at almost like 80,000 streams on Spotify with it. And now it's getting played on radio overseas, of all things. Like, never again in my million years of thoughts and whatnots, like, did I think that it was gonna do all this. And it just pushes me even more to keep doing music and to keep working hard, because this is hopefully, God willing, the first of many songs of mine that will be on radio. And, you know, the next one hopefully will be an original. We're currently in the studio working on original music. And I just, the fact that, you know, dreams are starting to not stay dreams anymore for me, they're becoming reality. That's the real special thing about this whole thing. You know, I never, the guy that was in Illinois before he moved to Nashville, like, dreamt about all this stuff. And, if he could just see all this, I think it'd make that guy back in Illinois so proud. Because that one, that guy before he left to go to Nashville, so full of fear, afraid that he didn't know if it was going to work out. And so much has happened in these 3 years and are continuing to happen that are just making everything worth it. And I can't say thank you enough to everyone who's believed in me and supported me and encouraged me and been there through everything. You know, you only get one radio debut. And actually, some people actually made a comment, and I was very open to it because they were like, didn't you technically make your radio debut in Nashville? And so in 2020, I did a radio show. And I was on it with some other artists in town, and we sang live. So that was technically like my radio debut, but they never played my song on the show, like afterwards. So in a way that was like, it was my first like live radio appearance in a sense. But this is the first time where a song that we went into the studio with and put out and is now getting recognized for something like this. This feels like one of those just check box moments where I'm now like, check. And I couldn't be more honored and humbled to say that I get to check that box. So without further ado, because I've been rambling on and I want to make this as authentic as possible, which is why I'm not stopping, I'm not editing, I'm just putting it as is. We're going to listen to it. This is the first time I've fully heard it. I just heard like a little clip, but we're going to listen to the whole thing together. So here we go.
Tickets. Ja, ik heb een goede vriend leren kennen in Amerika, Tyler, en die... Die heeft ook heel veel dingen al geholpen. Die heeft onder andere een optreden voor mij geregeld de laatste keer dat ik daar was. Dus hebben we samen een Songwriters Round gespeeld. En
I wish I knew what they were saying. I'm gonna have to message you up when this is over with Mick.
Echt what did y'all say? Dus dat lijkt me heel tof om hem wat airtime in Europa te gunnen. Ik denk dat hij dat ook heel tof vindt om te horen. Dus dat zou ik wel heel graag vinden.
Heel cool, tof, zelfs ook nieuwe Amerikaanse country-artiesten, dat heb ik ook nog nooit gedaan. Of wel, mocht ik ooit een radio show in Amerika krijgen, dan staat hij in ieder geval
meteen op mijn lijstje. Dus also gives me a good excuse now to learn Dutch.
Dus ja, leuk. Dan gaan we die platen draaien. More Hearts Than Mine heet.
I knew what that was.
Heeft hij nog meer andere muziek uitgebracht? Is dit zeg maar zijn echte...
Dit is zijn een beetje zijn doorbraak.
Oké. En hiermee gaat hij dus de rest van Nashville aanvallen.
Nashville,
nou goed, laten we hopen dat we samen met jou... dat jullie over weet ik hoeveel jaar dan samen een keer in Country Music Hall of Fame spelen.
Country Music Hall of Fame.
Kom ik ook kijken. Dit is More Than Hearts Than Mine, dus van Tyler Kors en Lucas Neer op RTV Maastricht.
I can't wait to show you where I grew up.
It's me.
And walking around the foothills of my town. Probably feel like you've been there before. After hearing all the stories I've been telling you for 6 months now, we'll probably have to sleep in separate bedrooms and pack a shirt for church because we'll go.
This is crazy.
I'm not trying to scare you all, but I just thought that we should talk new things out before we hit the road. So if I bring you on the mama, I guess I better warn you, she falls in love a little faster than I do. It might double check your tires, pour you whiskey over ice and take a fishing boat, pretend that he don't like you. Oh, if you break up, I'll be fine. But you'll be breaking more hearts than mine.
Y'all, this is so cool.
My sister's gonna ask a million questions. Say anything she can.
I've always done, like, first cover I ever did of the song. Like, I know Inger doesn't do it in the original, but I've always done it, and so it's stuck.
Bring you on, mama, I guess I better warn you. She falls in
Keegan added that, and I love the little echo part. This part coming up, Paul Merkovich, who's the music director of The Voice, came up with. Because he thought I needed bigger moments in the song than I did on the show, and I'm so thankful he gave me that, because it makes it so much better for me. And then Keegan came up with this part where I just kind of break it down at the end. It just adds so much to it.
Prachtige plaat. En nou, fijn dat we die ook bij de Nederlandse radio hebben kunnen draaien. Ik hoop dat hij er blij mee is. In de tussentijd heb jij...
That was my radio debut. That just happened, y'all. There is not enough thanks in the world right now to express everything going on in the heart that is currently in my chest. I'm thoroughly speechless, but in the best way possible. So thank you all again for all the encouragement and love and support that you have not only shown this song, but to me. And let's just keep working. Let's keep going at it, because there's so much stuff left that I have in me that we need to check off that list and that I want to put out there for the world. So this was my radio debut, and it happened overseas. Like, what? So yeah, thank you. Oh my gosh, it's like 13 minutes long. Okay. Thank you so much. Bye.